What is your favorite book and why would you suggest anyone to read it? Turtles All the Way Down. It is the most realistic depiction of being inside someone's head that has depression, anxiety, and OCD. Honestly helped me realize that I had major anxiety and depression by seeing how it works from the inside. Also, a murder mystery with teen romance in there too. 1984. What could happen if an authoritarian, totalitarian government has laws, regulations and power over not just your actions, but also your speech and even your thoughts? Have you read Brave New World? It's my favorite dystopian novel and I feel like it has more relevance in a post-Cold War society. A society so placated by comforts that people give up everything. The final chapter has an amazing speech about how some of the things that define human existence and make life worth living are some of the more painful experiences we endure. Soma is what they would take when hard times hit their eyes. Stormlight Archive. 1600-page self-help books disguised as the most badass epic fantasy you could ever read. Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. I've read it over 30 times and I still laugh at every joke. Lord of the Rings plus The Hobbit. The story is so relatable and well-written. The world is developed to an unbelievable scale. The Name of the Wind. For fantasy lovers, it's just so good. Watership Down by Richard Adams. It's a beautiful book that I could read many times over. You should read it if you want a book that's happy and exciting. Catch 22. It teaches you how to smell bullshit and get the hell out before it is too late. Oh, and it is funny as hell. OMG, read it and you will thank me later. It took me 3 tries to get past the middle of it. Glad I did. Very funny at times. I read Crime and Punishment in college. It was amazing. Seconded, was my favorite for many years. Dostoevsky. Okay, sign. To Kill a Mockingbird. I read it at least once a year. I've probably read it more than 30 times by now. Every time I read it, I find something new. When I was younger, I identified with the children in the story. As I grew older, I identified more with the father. Despite the things that happened in it, it always leaves me feeling better about the world and having hope in humanity. Knowing that, along with the bad people in the world, there are good people trying to do the right thing and that help can come from unexpected places. I remembered Homer complaining how useless that book is. Sure, it taught him not to judge people by the color of the skin, but it had absolutely no insight on how to kill mockingbirds. Catcher in the Rye. It's one of those books you have to read twice because the motifs are so intricate. Once was too many times for me. I hate that book with a burning passion. I have only met one person in real life who likes that book. Every other person I have met who has read it has hated it. I don't think there is a middle ground with this book. You either love it or hate it. I don't think it's possible to be ambivalent about it. Intellectually, I know there are people who like it. I just can't wrap my head around it, though. Oh man, I used to hate that book too because we read it in English class. So we had to overanalyze everything. I hated how it didn't seem to have a plot and how Holden seemed like an irritable asshole. But shit happened and when I went to reread it, I found it actually kind of relatable. Maybe I've turned into an irritable asshole lol. The Count of Monte Cristo. It has everything. Great characters. A love story. Betrayal. Violence. Vengeance. Action. An underdog. It's just literary perfection in my opinion. Every month, there's a post on our books by someone who just finished it and can't believe how good it is. It is superb. The Phantom Tollbooth. It has taught me the most important lesson regarding how you live your life and pursue the things that you feel need doing. I don't want to ruin it, but I also don't want to oversell it. The moral of this story is so absurdly beautiful and simple that even a young child like I was could understand and remember it enough to talk about it 30 years later. If you're at all an avid reader, you probably already have but read Harry Potter. I'm 28. I didn't read Harry Potter until 4-ish years ago. I avoided it because it was the cool thing at school. When they came out, so I didn't want to be associated with it. Then I noticed that Harry Potter is so important to my generation. Finally read them because they were on the bookshelf of the house I moved into. Freaking love them. Finally saw the movies, which I had also avoided. Pretty good movies as well. I wish I had experienced Harry Potter when they came out and I was basically the same age the characters. The Martian. Many people disregard it because they have seen the movie, which is it, but it's nowhere near as funny or interesting as the book. The book uses first person to the max in order to set up jokes. Some of them need sort of advanced scientific knowledge, but most are just funny. For example, pseudo spoilers, greater than. Also, I have duct tape, ordinary duct tape, like you buy at a hardware store. Turns out even NASA can't improve on duct tape. Less than. Is it the best written book? No. Does it have the best characters or plot? No. Is it the best sci-fi book? No. That goes to the Expanse series. But it is by far the most fun I've had reading a book, and it's definitely the most fun I've had rereading a book. Check it out, especially if you have seen the movie. This is a great book. Good character and storyline. Audiobook is just as good. Movie was not so good. Didn't work for me. Sapiens. It contains a wealth of scientific info but is profoundly philosophical as well. It's the opposite of philosophical, it's pragmatic. The Outsiders, it's so damn good. House of Leaves. I don't know if I'd suggest everyone read it, as it's pretty dense, but it's an absolute masterpiece of ergodic storytelling. Be warned though, you may have to read upside down and backwards in a few parts. Brandon Sanderson's Mistborn. It's fucking anime on a book. Have you read the Stormlight Archive series? I tried to buy the first book, but it's just too expensive for me to afford, sad face. The Book Thief. Beautifully written from start to finish. Heart-wrenchingly good. I was going to say this too. The perspective of Death narrating it too is a really nice, refreshing take on storytelling. It's a beautiful book and I recommend it to everyone. Funnily enough, it is the only thing I've ever stolen in my life. I got it out of my high school library and never returned it because I reread it again and again, and couldn't afford to buy a copy for myself. Foundation series by Isaac Asimov. In Cold Blood by Truman Capote. It's a fascinating and well-written true crime book. Capote really captures the fear and shock of a small town rocked by a quadruple murder, and the almost casual nature of the murderers lives after the murders happens. Blood Meridian is the best book written in the English language. In my opinion, it isn't for everyone. It is violent, and horrific, and brutal, but it is also beautiful. There is no better English prose. Stephen King has some good reads. The Dark Tower series comes to mind. Also, there are a lot of good books on the Halo series that go really into the depth of the lore. Wizard in Glass is one of the best stories I've ever read. The whole Dark Tower series is great, but that book is something else. Anything by Terry Pratchett, it's freaking hilarious, and the entire series will take you years to get through. Yep, the early Discworld books are much more lighthearted, but they get so good later while still preserving the wordplay and sheer readability. The books have so many levels, and manage to be fun and funny while having a such good satirical look at people, societies, religions, etc. The man was a genius. Me Talk Pretty One Day by David Sedaris. Honest, insecure and funny, really. Any book by him is worth a read. Calypso, for me, maybe the best combination of eyes pissing tears from laughter and sadness, sincerity ever. The Giver by Lois Lowry will always be my favorite book. It's a really interesting take on a sci-fi, fake utopian world, 100 years of solitude. The way Garcia Marquez creates a realistic yet magical world is simply fantastic, and perfectly sums up the history and spirit not only of Colombia, but the whole of Latin America. If you can read it in the original Spanish, do it. Of Mice and Men, because it's a classic. Everyone should read it once. Have you read any other Steinbeck? He was an amazing storyteller. Grapes of Wrath stands out as one of my favorite books. East of Eden is a must-read as well. I'm a big fan of Travels with Charlie, but a lot of people shit on that one. I could talk about Steinbeck all day. Steinbeck has to be one of my favorite authors of all time. Do I have to choose? The book that had the most profound impact on me was To Kill a Mockingbird. I first read it when I was 9, and it blew me away. I've always been interested in race relations and class relations, but I never heard it in a story before. Scout was about my age, which made the read even more impactful. At that time, I was attending a very unliberal school where racism was accepted and even encouraged. The timing for reading the book was perfect, and I grew with Scout as the book progressed. It helped me understand my surroundings because, like Scout, I had no idea what was going on. It remains my favorite book of all time, as it was the book that made me truly understand racism. The book that got me interested in reading was Harry Potter. I was very low academically, and I befriended a girl who moved in my neighborhood. She was much older than I, and she helped me learn how to read. Then, she told me to read Harry Potter, and I absolutely adored it. It took 7-year-old me 3 weeks to read The Sorcerer's Stone, but I felt a great sense of accomplishment once I finished it. I don't know what it did, but it helped my academic performance immensely. Those two books really shaped me into who I am today. I also have to thank Orwell, but I wrote an answer a few days ago proclaiming my love for High Monsieur. I feel like having a main character that's your age just makes books so much more impactful. One of my favorite series is Percy Jackson, and when I first read it I was 12. Percy's age in the first book, it just makes it so much easier to picture what they're going through at that age because you're the same age and probably think at least a little similarly. I feel like everyone has something to enjoy from the All Creatures books by James Herriot. They're well written, funny, lighthearted enough to be easy reading, but liberally sprinkled with deep medical and veterinary knowledge. At times they can be sort of a mystery story, and show a happy human being's life of hard work and fulfillment. There's just a lot to love in those books, and they manage to be really entertaining. Also, there's a great love story, Shades of Grey, not 50 Shades of Grey. Shades of Grey by Jasper Ford. It's bizarre and dystopian and it's funny but also eye-opening. Some random tidbits to maybe entice you. Everyone primarily sees one color and the rest is grey. The animals have barcodes on them. Spoons are almost currency. They have lost the ability to see in low light. I don't know how to explain such a quirky book, but I think if you like dystopian novels or Brave New World, you'd like it. Skullduggery Pleasant. It's a series of books that I love. It has a similar vibe to Harry Potter but snarkier and a talking skeleton. Catch 22. It convinced me to believe in myself. Anne McCaffrey, Todd McCaffrey, The Pern series. It was the first set of adult books I read. This was at a time when I was grounded from reading as a punishment. My cousin smuggled the books to me. I still have the first one, Dragon's Eye. It took me to another world where I could pretend I had power and could change things. The Road by Cormac McCarthy. Written in the simplest form possible. No chapters, little punctuation, simple matter-of-fact wording. It's incredibly easy to read, which is good because the content itself is extremely depressing and dire. It's awful. I love it. Second this. The Road is a super good, easy read. On a side note, I have always found the book-to-movie adaption if The Road to be one of the best book-to-movie adaptions I have seen. Rot and Ruin, Just Do It. I love The Christmas Carol. It's a great representation of how the working class suffered in Victorian England, and there's some great Schrechter development, not to mention all the symbolism packed into the Schrechter's descriptions. Literally every simile has some kind of deeper meaning. The tone might seem bleak at times, considering it's trying to push a certain kind of morals and point of view, and it does that. Basically, low guilt by the end. Seeing how everything ends well and how happy everyone is. The tone is so much warmer and merrier. My favorite part of the whole book is just how feel-good the ending is and the beautiful descriptions of Christmas through the whole book. I'm sorry for my huge rant, but this is my favorite book of all time and I get really overexcited whenever people ask about it. Red Heart. GCSE English gave me a strong hatred for that book. The amount of times I had to read it over and over was painful. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.